Hello and a very warm welcome to the channel, everyone. So as you already know by the caption that today I'm going to give you guys the feedback about my Himalayan, the BS4 version, which I purchased almost around 4 months ago. And I had also made a video earlier for the review of the same. It was a 2000 kilometers review. And now I have completed 10,000 kilometers, 10,300 to be specific. And my experience with the bike so far has been really great. So let's begin then. I'll continue to talk while I ride, and I'll also show you some clips about how and where I rode the bike for like 8,206 kilometers. A lot of you must be knowing by now that I was on my expedition to Leh Ladakh from Bangalore. That is how I completed 10,000 plus kilometers on this bike within 4 months itself. So let's begin. So the speeds that I've been cruising throughout my ride was somewhere between 90 kilometers per hour to 120 at times. And I really feel this bike is very comfortable till 120 kilometers. And if you are someone who cruises above that, I think a Dominar would be a better option for you. But as per the Indian road conditions, 120 is quite a decent speed. Actually, it's like 20 kilometers per hour more than what we should ride in. However, it's everybody's personal preference, and you can ride it the way you do. And as you can see on the speedometer right now, I'm easily cruising at 120 kilometers with no issues. The bike goes up till 120 easily, and while on highways you will not find any issues with the bike while riding at 120. My only concern while riding on high speeds with the Himalayan is that it does not have a tubeless tire. It has a tubed tire, which could be risky at times, because if the tire gets punctured on this speed and if you can't control the bike, you will be in deep trouble. Like while I was coming back from Leh Ladakh, I had issues. Like I got two punctures, one after another. So one was in Haryana while coming back, and second was in Karnataka. Both time I was cruising on around 110. Luckily, I did not fall off the bike. The bike did not skid, and it kind of drifted, and I had to slow down immediately as soon as possible and then take it to the left hand side and park it. However, the bike was still pretty much in control. However, but you will still, you know, it scares the shit out of you. So while cruising on high speed, this is something that you need to take care of. Apart from that, as the video clip continues, you'll see where and how and all the places that we rode through. We rode through ice, desert, snow. When I say ice, the frozen snow is called ice because it snowed, and after that the snow was frozen. Then it becomes ice, like a transparent layer. So we took this bike through extreme conditions in minus 15, minus 20 degree temperature, and throughout my bike did not give me any issues. The grip while riding it in the mud or gravel or water is like 1 foot deep or more than that. I did not face any issues. Even in the snow, the bike would start on the first cell and no major issues. If you take a close look right now while I'm riding through the truck, it's actually very steep here, kind of risky, but I could tackle the bike very easily. And this water crossing was at least 1.5 feet deep. However, the bike went out of it hassle free. I did not struggle at all. So for those of you who don't know, I'm just 5 feet and 5 inches tall. However, I can easily manage to ride this bike throughout extreme conditions. All over India I rode, and I did not face any issues. The only issue I faced with the bike is the weight, because I am myself just 64 or 65 kgs, and the bike is, like everybody knows, Royal Enfields are heavy. So that was one of the problem for me. But people who are taller than me and like are well built, you should have no issues with this bike. That I can promise, or you can trust my words on that. And adding on to that, the mileage that I got throughout my ride is around 30 kilometers per liter to 32 liters per liter, 32 kilometers per liter in any condition. I mean, when I was cruising on highway, I would get 32 kilometers per liter. While off-roading and roads as such, you can see on the screen, I got somewhere around 29 to 30. So the overall mileage was 30 or 31 kilometers, we can say that. And my clutch wire did not break even once, nor did the accelerator cable, nor I did not face any issues with the bike throughout my ride, to be very honest. This is not a paid or a sponsored video. This is just an honest opinion about the bike. With that said, I had three major luggage on my bike throughout my whole ride. So I had a pair of saddlebags on each side and a top bag on the rear seat, and which was very heavy. I had a lot of stuff, unnecessary stuff. I should not have carried those, but yeah, still I did. And so the bike was quite heavy, but maintaining this bike or balancing this bike is pretty good. As long as the bike is riding or is in motion, you don't have to worry about it, because it's kind of self-balancing. Like I said the same thing in my previous video, and I observed the same during my ride to the world's highest motorable road, Khardungla, the one of the mightiest passes, Zojila Pass and Changla Pass. So as long as the bike is in motion, you need not to worry about it. Even in snow, when we fell down, it was only when the bike stopped, or we had to stop the bike and my legs would not, you know, completely take the grip on the ground because of snow or the ice and my height, of course. So that is the issues that I faced with the bike. Apart from that, nothing much. Also, the cornering on this bike is really wonderful. I mean, up to 80-90 kilometers per hour, I did not fear or face any issues while cornering on the bike. I was feeling a little inconfident when I was trying to corner the bike around 100. It could be because of the luggage or the overload on my bike, I'm not sure. But till 80-90 kilometers, I had no issues while cornering the bike. And the suspension part is also really great. I mean, there was a time when we rode for 27 hours straight, covering a distance of 1300-1400 kilometers without sleeping. So we were continuously riding and taking breaks for like 15-20 minutes. We'd ride again for 100-150 kilometers and again stop for a while. And we did 27 hours of riding and covered 1300-1400 kilometers. Still, when we reached home, no body ache. So the suspension, the seat cushioning is extremely good, and the stock tires are beautiful as well. They will hold onto the roads and you will face no issues with it. So in my opinion, this bike is really a game changer for Royal Enfield. The BS4 version, the BS3 version was pathetic. The Himalayan BS3 was like literally pathetic, and I would never like to ride that bike. But this does not have vibrations until 100, or once you cross 100, you might feel minor vibrations, nothing major, but that's manageable. And the tires are pretty good. I mean, throughout this ride, the puncture happened once we came back, and that too because of the nails that are purposefully thrown on the roads. That is what I've heard, that it happens, and in my experience, it is true. However, the nails tore off the tube. But I was carrying a pair of tube with me, and the puncture kit as well, also an air pump. So I was pretty well prepared, because I knew that I was riding a Royal Enfield and it comes with tube tires. So it's better to be prepared. With that said, guys, experience with this bike so far has been really great. I am totally in love with this machine, unless it gets punctured. But nothing to worry, I opened up the tire when myself and I replaced the tube and fixed it bad. It's no major deal. Because I was doing it for the first time, it took me a hell lot of time. But I'm pretty confident that if I have to do this again, it's not going to take me much time and I'll be able to do it in a better time frame. And it's quite an easy job as well. All you need to do is to take up your bike on the main stand. That is a trouble if you are loaded, as much as I was. But any helping hand would do that. So that's pretty much about it. So about my ride, I went from Bangalore to Leh Ladakh and came back, covering a distance of 8,206 kilometers in 23-24 days. And as you have seen the video, I've almost ridden it everywhere. So that is about it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I've tried to be as honest as possible. And please share your thoughts in the comment section below. Do subscribe to the channel if you like my videos. And the whole series of Leh Ladakh is coming up really soon. I already posted a trailer and two videos, day 1 and day 2, on my channel. I'll share the link in the description box. And I hope you guys enjoy it. So that is about it, folks. If you have any other questions, feel free to write them in the comment section and I'll be more than happy to answer all of them. Alright people, so stay tuned and take care. Bye-bye.